Most awaiting event in women's life after marriage is of course the baby shower event, where she wants to share her joy of a new life, as well as she wants that her baby get lots and lots of blessings. So planning an event is a big deal. So you need to do research, planning and execution of many things. So if you are thinking to plan your baby shower, then this video is for you, because in this video I'm going to share with you all the tips on how to plan your baby shower. I'm going to divide this topic into three videos, so this is part one, so stay tuned. Hi mums and cute babies, welcome to ICAREBABY. Myself is Asim. I make videos related to parenting, pregnancy and baby care. If you are new to my channel, then definitely click subscribe. Subscription is absolutely free and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll get notified when we upload new video. Also, help ICAREBABY to reach out to 50,000 subscribers. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Pinterest and Instagram. Planning your big day at least 3 to 4 months ahead is very important. In this way, you will get time to try out your choices, as well as you will be able to figure out which are the things which fit your expectation. So it's important to come up with an estimated budget so you can decide how much you would like to spend for the event. Take an example, say if you have decided to spend $2,000 or $3,000 for the event, then you can decide how you would like to distribute it. So it's a good idea to break down it and make a list of things such as venue, decoration, entertainment, food, written gift, photo and video shoot, cost on extra equipments such as speaker, presenters, etc. So in this way you will be able to figure out where to spend more and where to spend less. Analyzing your estimated budget, it's important to prepare the list of guests. That means you need to decide how many guests you would like to invite for the event, because increase in the guest list will affect on food, beverages, written gift, as well as if you are making their travel arrangement, then that too. So basically impacting your budget. I personally prefer to limit the number of guests based on the event. So in this way you get the time to interact with them, you guys get quality time, as well as you can too enjoy the event. When searching for the venue, you need to consider a couple of things such as location, what type of services they are providing, inclusion and exclusion. What are the rates for additional services such as cleaning services, catering, etc. Picking the right date for the event is also very important, because you need to make sure that your guests are available on the same day to come to your event, as well as you need to make sure that your venue is available on the same date. So prepare a list of questions to ask before visiting the venue. Check with them how many people they can accommodate. What about increase or decrease in the guest list? What services they are providing, such as catering services? If not, then are they allowing to bring the outside food or the outside caterer? Along with that, it's also important to check the decoration, if they are allowing that or not. If they are allowing, then how many hours before you can come to do the decoration? Or they are providing any packages or option for the same, how much it will cost you. So check all the criteria, visit various places and then make your final decision. Sending invitation ahead of time will get you some time to get the RSVP from your guest, as well as you'll be in better position to decide on food and other things. So you can go for the traditional approach of sending invitations and getting RSVP by call or text, Or if you want to save some money, you can always go for online options such as evite.com or punchbowl.com, where you can send the free invitation card as well as you can track the RSVP. Once you confirm your guest list, now it's a time to decide on menu. So prepare at least two options for the menu. Check with your caterer whether they will be able to provide you the options which you are looking for. When deciding the menu for the baby shower event, also consider a couple of points, such as what time of the day you want to throw the party, whether it's a daytime party or the nighttime party, as well as also check for the time of the year, whether it is a winter, summer, fall, etc. If you have planned to throw the theme party, then your food option should also go along with the theme. It's important to be organized, so it's good to use the mobile app. I personally use the Wonderlist. It really works like wonder for me and my family. So definitely try that option. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. So don't forget to give a thumbs up, share and subscribe. Subscription is absolutely free and help ICAREBABY to reach out to 50,000 subscribers. Don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you will get notified when we upload new videos. So, till then, ciao!